Dear students, in the previous three classes of the course, Principles of Seed Technology, the basic aspects related to seed structures, development and maturation, germination, dormancy, seed senescence, and qualities of good seeds were dealt with. In this session, we shall learn about varietal deterioration and its causes, and also how to maintain the genetic purity during seed production. Seed production is a systematic and scientific approach of mass multiplication of seed with assured quality as per the Indian government recommendations. The multiplied seeds should possess better quality characters specific to the genetic and physical purity. Seed is a biological entity amenable to any change. Hence, it is the responsibility of the seed producer to maintain the genetic purity, physical purity, and physiological quality of any product produced as seed. Production of genetically pure seed requires high technical skills and comparatively heavy financial investment. During seed production, strict attention must be given to the maintenance of genetic purity and other qualities of seed in order to exploit the full dividends sought to be obtained by introduction of new superior crop plant varieties. In other words, seed production must be carried out under standardized and well organized conditions. In Tamil, we used to say, Vinai vidaithavan vinai arupan, thinai vidaithavan thinai arupan. Likewise, in English, as you sow, shall you reap. The principles of seed production are broadly classified as genetic and agronomic principles. The genetic principles has to be taken care with seed multiplication, as continuous usage of varieties may lead to genetic deterioration, or otherwise the genetic purity of seed will be deteriorated and the originality of the variety could not be obtained on further multiplication. In general, the success of agronomic principles rests with genetic principles, which reveals on the genetic purity of the base seed used for multiplication. The genetic deterioration occur in the seed as suggested by Kadam 1942, and they are developmental variations, mechanical mixtures, mutations, natural crossings, minor genetic variations, selective influence of pests and diseases, the techniques of the plant breeder. Let us now see one by one. First one, the developmental variations. The basic variations in plant characters could be developed and may set in as differential growth responses if the seed crop is grown under environment with differing soil fertility, climate, photoperiods, or at different elevations for several consecutive generations. It is therefore preferred to grow the varieties of crops in the areas of their natural adaptation to minimize developmental shifts. The second one is mechanical mixtures. Mechanical mixtures, the most important reason for varietal deterioration, often take place at the time of sowing if more than one variety is sown with the same seed drill, through volunteer plants of the same crop in the seed field, or through different varieties grown in adjacent fields. Fields of two varieties growing next to each other, the seed is usually mixed during harvesting and threshing operations. The threshing equipment is often contaminated with seeds of other varieties. Similarly, the gunny bags, seed bins, and elevators are also often contaminating, adding to mechanical mixtures of varieties. Roguing the seed fields critically and using utmost care during seed production and processing are necessary to avoid such mechanical contamination. The next one is mutations. Mutations do not seriously deteriorate varieties. It is often difficult to identify or detect minor mutations occurring naturally. Mutants such as fatuoids in oats or rabbit ear in peas may be removed by roguing from seed plot to purify the seeds. Next one is natural crossing. Natural crossing is an important source of varietal deterioration, especially in sexually propagated crops. The extent of contamination depends upon the magnitude of natural cross fertilization. The deterioration sets in due to natural crossing with undesirable types, diseased plants or off types. In self-fertilized crops, natural crossing is not a serious source of contamination unless variety is male sterile and is grown in close proximity with other varieties. Natural crossing, however, can be the major source of contamination due to the breeding system of the species, isolation distance, varietal mass and pollinating agents. The isolation of seed crops is a most important factor in avoiding contamination of cross-fertilized crops. The direction of prevailing winds, the number of insects present and their activity and mass of varieties are also important considerations in contamination by natural crossing. It can be prevented by adoption of precaution against cross-pollination. The next one is minor genetic variations. Minor genetic variations can occur even in varieties appearing phenotypically uniform, that is, they look similar in their external appearance and homogeneous when released. The variations may be lost during later production cycles owing to the selective elimination by the nature. The use of pure breeder seeds in self-pollinated crop varieties can overcome these minor variations. Due care during the maintenance of nucleus and breeder seeds of often fertilized crop varieties is necessary to avoid these minor genetic variations. The next one is selective influence of pests and diseases. New crop varieties often are susceptible to newer races of pests and diseases caused by obligate parasites and thus selectively influence deterioration. The vegetatively propagated stock also can deteriorate quickly if infected by virus, fungi or bacteria. Seed production under strict disease-free conditions is therefore essential. The next one is the techniques of the plant breeder. Serious instabilities may occur in varieties owing to the cytogenetic irregularities in the form of improper assessments in the release of new varieties. Premature release of varieties still segregating for resistance and susceptibility to diseases or other factors can cause significant deterioration of varieties. This failure can be attributed to the variety testing program. In addition to these factors, other heritable variations due to recombinations and polyploidization may also take place in varieties during seed production, which can be avoided by periodical selection during maintenance of the seed stock. Of all these factors, mechanical mixtures, natural crossing, and selective influence of diseases are the most important reasons for genetic deterioration of varieties during seed production, followed by raising the crop in areas outside their adoption, which may cause developmental variation and genetic shifts in varieties. Of all these factors, please remember that mechanical mixtures, natural crossing, and selective influence of diseases are the most important factors for genetic deterioration. Then you may be in doubt how to maintain genetic purity. In any seed production plot, the genetic purity has to be maintained with proper care as against the genetic deterioration by avoiding genetic contaminants. The source of contaminants are volunteer plants, off types, specific disease infection, that is designated diseases, weeds, that is objectionable weeds, and inseparable other crop seeds. For example, you can take barley, oats, wheat and rye. The causes on occurrence of off types are presence of some recessive genes in heterozygous conditions at the time of release of varieties. The recessive genes may also arise by mutation. The heterozygous plants segregate and give rise to off types. The next one is volunteer plants arising from accidentally planted seeds or from seed produced by earlier crops. Next one is mechanical mixtures, which constitute the major source of breakdown in genetical homogeneity. Hence, a precautionary measure, off-type plants should be roped out of the seed production fields before pollination occurs. Regular supervision by trained personnel is imperative, and it may be necessary to control specific seed-borne disease infection like designated diseases, weeds like objectionable weeds, and inseparable other crop seeds. In addition to these factors, other heritable variations due to recombination and polyploidization may also take place in varieties during seed production, which can be avoided by periodical selection during maintenance of the seed stock. Next, we shall see about the maintenance of genetic purity. Several measures have been suggested to safeguard the genetic purity, and we shall see one by one. The first one is adoption of crop, that is growing the crops only in areas of their adaptation to avoid genetic shifts. Next one is use of approved class of seeds. Only approved class of seeds in seed multiplication and adopt the generation system should be used. Next one is preceding crop requirement. Inspection and approval of seed plots prior to planting has to be carried out. Next factor is isolation of seed crop, because isolation of seed crops from various sources of contamination by natural crossing or mechanical admixtures are very essential. The isolation of seed crops from various sources of contamination is also a necessary requirement for raising seed crops. Contamination may be due to natural crossing with other varieties grown alongside and off types present in the same field. Contamination may be also due to mechanical mixtures at the time of sowing, harvesting, threshing, processing and handling of seeds, and contamination may also be due to seed-borne diseases from nearby fields. So, protection from these sources of contamination is absolutely necessary for maintaining genetic purity and the good quality of the seed. The next most important step you have to take is roguing. What is roguing? Roguing is removal of unwanted plants. So, roguing of off-types differing in their characteristics from those of the seed variety is very important. The existence of off-type plants, that is plants which differ in their characteristics from those of the seed variety, is another potent source of genetic contamination. Although a low percentage of such plants may not seriously jeopardize the genetic purity of the variety, their continued presence will certainly deteriorate the genetic purity of the variety. The removal of such plants is referred to as roguing. Next step you have to take is field inspections. For field inspection, qualified and experienced personnel of seed certification agency has to inspect the seed crops at all appropriate stages of growth, and they have to verify the seed lots for purity and quality. And another most important step is seed certification. The genetic purity in commercial seed production is often maintained through a system of seed certification. To accomplish these purposes, qualified and well experienced personnel of seed certification agency carry out field inspections at appropriate stages of crop growth. They also make seed inspections to verify the seed crop or seed lot which is of the requisite genetic purity and quality, after harvesting to verify the quality, and at the seed processing plants they draw samples for seed testing and sometimes for conducting grow out tests also. The genetic purity of seed is thus assured if the certification agency has approved the seed. Next step is post harvest handling operations. After harvest, for drying the seeds, we take the seeds to the threshing floor. Hence, the threshing floor should be clean, the crevices and cracks in the threshing floor should be cleaned properly, the blown seeds grown near the threshing floor should be cleaned properly. Two crops or two varieties should not be harvested and threshed at the same time. On use of winnowers or threshers for seed extraction, the machinery should be well cleaned without any seed using air blow or aspirator. On processing, the floors and machine should be cleaned. On packing, only fresh bags should be used to avoid mixing of seed with previous handled seed. Adhere in between the network of jute thread. Important post-harvest operations for genetic purity maintenance as per the seed certification program will vary among the crops. For example, in maize, we have to follow cob sorting. That is, we have to sort out the maize cobs as per their size, shape, based on the effect of metazinia or zinia. And in groundnut, we have to carry out pod verification. That is, based on the shape, size, the nature of the beak of the groundnut pods. In cotton, we follow kappa sorting. Likewise, in vegetable propagules, we have to verify the sets or rhizomes or tubers or bulbs or roots which are used for further multiplication of crops. The genetic purity required for different classes of seed varies as per seed certification standards. For example, for breeder seed, the minimum genetic purity should be 100%. For foundation seeds, the genetic purity should be 99%. For certified seeds, including varieties, composites, synthetics, and multilines, the genetic purity should be 98%. For hybrids, the minimum genetic purity should be 95%. For confirmation of genetic purity, we have to adopt grow-out tests. That is, the varieties being grown for seed production are to be periodically tested for genetic purity by grow-out test to make sure that they are being maintained in their true form. Okay, students, in this session so far, you have learnt about various causes of varietal deterioration and you have also learnt about how to maintain the genetic purity during seed production and also various important safeguards for maintaining the genetic purity during seed production. Last but not the least, I would like to stress as a seed technologist that care with seed and joy with harvest.